So what I have here is 5 tips on how you can rapidly improve your efficiency and your creativity in Photoshop. So I think this is a great way to start out the year. So the first tip I'm gonna give you, and this is the biggest time saver you could possibly have, is learn keyboard shortcuts. And here's a quick example of some of my favorite keyboard shortcuts. So here's a cheat sheet I have with keyboard shortcuts. I can take a screen capture, or I'll also give you a link where you can download that for free. So there's a lot of things we could do with keyboard shortcuts that just save so much time. For example, say I'm using the elliptical marquee tool. You know how hard it is to draw from the center. Very, very hard to try and get that. But if I hold down the space bar, I can move this around and then I can continue drawing. So it makes it much easier. If I hold the shift key, it'll constrain it to perfect circle. If I hold down alt or option, notice it draws from the center. I can hold option and shift and then just tap my finger over and then I can make a circle. And notice how quickly I can go over there and just position that. Now, if I wanted to copy this to a new layer, I could hit Control J, and that will give us that on a new layer. Of course, it leaves it there, it leaves it intact. Had I gone here and I hold down Control Shift J, what it will do is actually cut it out and put it on a new layer. There's other things we can do with the Move tool. The V key will grab the Move tool. Hold down the Alt or the Option key, I can drag out copies of this. So we can do that. If we wanted to select all of these, hold down the Control key and then click and drag around and we can make a selection and we can select all these. We can align them, we can distribute them. There's all kinds of things. Okay, now could you imagine if I wasn't using keyboard shortcuts, how long it would have taken to have done this? And the second tip I have for you is something that is really overlooked a lot, and this can elevate the appearance of your images as well as your productivity, and that's using readily available assets. For example, using textures, stock, even AI. So you can do things like use your phone as a creative tool. You can use things like Adobe Capture, or you can even take photographs of different textures and overlay them in your images. Another thing is Adobe Stock has a free collection. And I'll show you how to access all those free photos now. Okay, so here's an example of using Adobe Stock. Say I want some kind of a texture. I can just type in texture, and then when I'm searching here, hit the arrow and then choose Adobe Stock. And now it's actually going to go into Adobe Stock and look at all the collections. Now I could save this as a preview, and we'll add it to the library. And at that point, I can just double click and it'll open. What it's going to do is it's going to give you a watermarked version, but we can also get unwatermarked high resolution ones for free. Let me show you how. Okay, go to stock.adobe.com. But what we're going to do is change from all to free. And now we can search textures. All right, so now we can go in here and look at this. There's 75,000 free textures that we can use. And these can really elevate our images. For example, let's say this one here, it's free. I want to license it. I click on license and it's going to add it to my library. Now I created a default library. You can choose manage here if you wanted. And then you can just create a new library name. Just type it in or just click the one that you want it to go to and see what we can do there. It will move it to that default library. Okay, so here I am back in Photoshop. Under the libraries, you can choose. Remember, we changed it to 2022. There it is. And I can just double click it to open it, or I can drag it onto the image, change the blending mode, maybe add a mask, soft edge brush. Before and after. And that's just one example of how I can use overlays, photos, textures, different things. And another one that's a little controversial right now, which I did a video on a few months ago, which is AI. I've got another one planned where I can actually show you how you can use this as a creative tool to increase your productivity. You can see here's a lot of resources I'm going to give you. Ebooks, action packs, we've got cloud packs that gives you the full resolution images you can use for sky replacements. There's that keyboard shortcut cheat sheet. We've got LUTs, brushes, presets, the whole thing. Now, if you already receive our newsletter, you don't need to go here. It's included at the bottom of every single newsletter. Just click on it and you can download directly. If you haven't yet signed up, throw your email address in here. You'll get a link where you can get all this stuff for free, as well as receive a weekly tutorial on our newsletter. And the third tip I'm going to give you, and this is actually the most powerful tip I could possibly give you when it comes to increasing the quality of your images, and that's to be observant, to look. Number one, look at things, look at nature, look at the way light interacts. And this is going to help you with your design, your illustration, your photography, everything. Let me give you an example. I like to ask people a question. When you see chrome, what color is it? And most people say silver. But it's not. If you just glance at it quickly, yes, it could appear to be silver. But if you really look at chrome, what it's doing is reflecting the environment. All the different colors are there if you look closely. So rather than just merely glancing at things, shadows, light, caustics, and water, take a close look and actually see what is it that gives it this essence. Say, for example, what makes glass look like glass? How do you know it's transparent? Like, you can see it. So if it's transparent, how can you see it? Because you're seeing things like reflections, distortions, displacement. So start to take notice of these things. And as you apply this to your work, it will really just set it above everybody else's. And another thing on that same vein is, don't forget to check out other people's work. I'm not saying you should copy people, but look for inspiration. You know, maybe it's not quite so good these days, Instagram, but you can still find some pictures on there when it's not all reels. But there's other things. There's magazines or digital magazines. There's books. And to give an example of how much I really do believe in books, I've actually written 21 books throughout my career as a way to share my knowledge with people. You know, starting with, this is one of my first books. It was a Photoshop 6 book, not CS6, but actually Photoshop 6. This is back in 2001. You know, I was in a couple of editions of New Masters of Photoshop, and all the way up to my latest book, which just came out, and that's my book on drones and drone photography, and I share a lot of images. But one of the things I've done in all my books is try to add as many inspirational images as I can to kind of inspire people, because I know I can gain a lot of inspiration by looking at work. So what you want to do is you want to bottle that inspiration and then turn it into something, remix it, turn it into something of your own. The fourth tip I'm going to give you, and that is build the core skills. There's certain things in Photoshop, you know, that you can memorize, like keyboard shortcuts, menus, how to use different things. But, and there's certain areas in Photoshop that actually do require practice and skills. These are things like the brushes, like dodging and burning, painting. The more you do it, the better you're going to get at it. Okay, one example of using brushes to dress up an image. We're just going to create a new layer by holding down the Alt or the Option key. And then we'll change the blend mode to overlay. Click OK. Now we're going to paint with white to add light. So hit the D key to reset foreground background colors, X key. So we just choose white as our foreground. Let's drop our flow down to 10%, that's shift 1. If you're using pen pressure, hit the brush settings, set transfer to pen pressure. If not, you can just paint with a mouse. All right, and then we can literally just go in now and just start to paint in here and start to make it look like the sun's hitting certain parts of the image. And if we look at what I've done before, after, and that's just one little, tiny area of the image in just a few seconds. And then other things like selections or using the pen tool. Find some of these core tools that maybe you struggle with. I've got tutorials on how to use all of these on the channel. Check those out. But really spend a little bit of time with these tools, maybe even 10 minutes a day, and start to build your muscle. It's like going to the gym. And as you get these core skills and you get stronger at them, you're going to find that you're going to be quicker, and it's going to be much easier for you to do everything inside of Photoshop. The fifth tip I'm going to give you is use resources. One valuable resource is photoshopcafe.com, where I've been doing this since the year 2000. This is the 23rd year that I've been writing tutorials and adding tips. Have a browse on the website. You can click on free tutorials here, see all the tutorials, or you could go under a category and look at the different categories of tutorials. You can also go here and you can look under category, or you can search. Most of these tutorials that I do each week here on YouTube, I'm actually also putting on Photoshop Cafe, but including written steps. And so these written steps can help you kind of slow down, go at your own pace, and really start to get a grasp of these skills. And a bonus thing that's going to help you is always be aware of the new tools and new techniques that are coming out. Don't resist them. Don't fight them. Learn them and see if they're for you. And on that vein, if you haven't yet subscribed, hit the subscribe button, and that way you won't miss any of the tutorials that I put out where I introduce you to new features and new techniques. So anyway, thanks for watching. Let me know in the comments underneath, what are your goals this year in Photoshop? What is the areas that maybe you're the weakest at that you would love to improve the most? Let me know, and maybe that'll inspire some of the tutorials this year going forward. And do me a favor, if you like this, hit the like button. Helps with the YouTube algorithm. And until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.